this crowd decked out in purple, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football, folks, as the Vikings get set to do battle with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. Charles Davis and Charles, you look at this Vikings ball club. They too come in off the bye, so we should have two teams that are eager to get back at it.
And players are creatures of habit. You can bet they enjoyed the time off, but you know they're also ready to get right back into the swing of things.
Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. A good-looking return set up here. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. Here comes this Dallas offense led by Dak Prescott in his sixth season now as the Cowboy quarterback.
And you got to think that they've got to be feeling pretty fresh. You know, coming off of the open week, didn't have to play, right? Gives him a chance to rest up a little bit, heal some of those aches and pains, and excited about playing again. That really rekindles things a little bit. I want to see how they come out and establish themselves here early.
And that bye week coming right where they want it, in the middle of the schedule. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20-point score gives yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
On second down, once more. Just a couple on the ground there. That's going to bring up third and about six. Well, this defense, very strong in that victory from a week ago.
Yeah, what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down, and they're playing with extreme confidence.
This defense looking for an early start. This is third down and six. There's Prescott. It's off the screen to Elliott. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys. So Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath, maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone getting their feet wet early.
He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time, left it in the clock, and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run, and just lost track, and it cost it.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game. Looking to throw, Prescott. A little underneath here to Elliott, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago. So Dak with a completion there, really showing no ill effects from that injury a season ago. Yeah, what do you think your keys are defensively trying to stop Mr. Prescott?
Well, I think any defensive coordinator will tell you, stop his running game first, because he is at his best off of play action. Scrimmage after the fake to the running back, and that allows him room and space to make a decision downfield. So take away the run, and that allows you to drop into coverage and blanket the field.
A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and two. first before he's taken down at the 36. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory, but they're picking up.
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Prescott from the gun. And there's Amari Cooper, his first catch. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A good-looking drive for the Cowboys so far. It's a first down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way gun. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
There's a run on first down and won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. He will lose a yard, second and 11.
One of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
They're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Now back to the ground with Elliott. He's going to get 4 out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
To throw on 2nd and 6. Prescott, he rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by linebacker Eric Harris. Catch the 2-11-yard line. And that's where the return stops. The Minnesota offense ready to go to work here. Their quarterback in his 10th season overall now, and 4th is a Viking, Kirk Cousins.
And you've got to think that they've got to be feeling pretty fresh. You know, coming off of the open week, didn't have to play, right? Gives them a chance to rest up a little bit, heal some of those aches and pains, and excited about playing again. That really rekindles things a little bit. I want to see how they come out and establish themselves here early.
And that bye week coming right where they want it, in the middle of the schedule. Cousins and the Vikings with a 1st and 10 at their own 11. They'll set up to throw from the gun. And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get safety. We thought these two defenses, they might come to play. One has already come to play here, a safety for the opening points of the game.
Brandon, let's file this play away, because if it turns out to be a tight game, who knows? This could wind up being the difference.
safety, you give the football up as well, and they free kick it from the 20 now. Fielded at the 20. Zeke and the Cowboys ready to begin their next drive. Those are his numbers through roughly the first half of the season, and given that, you'd have to think he's on pace for a 1,000-yard campaign.
Steady as he goes, steady goes the offense, but you know what else is happening, too, because they are a team now recognized with the ability to run the football. You've got to be able to throw it better now, right? Better throwing lanes, better opportunities for the guys downfield, maybe more one-on-one coverage, which you should be able to beat easier. Yeah, he's establishing not just a tone, but an identity for his team.
And that's a discussion we had a couple days ago in the team meetings, talking about this running game opening up the passing game. We'll see if that continues to happen. And now after the delay of game, they're operating behind the sticks, second and 15. Prescott to throw it. Two now. Here's first and 10. Following the interception, Cousins. And the pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. Well, that's tough, Charles. First play of the drive, you're hoping to stay ahead of schedule. You take that huge sack, and now you're facing second and a mile.
And the entire time, you were probably thinking the same thing I was. Either get rid of the ball, safely, of course, or go down. The yardage he gave up on that play, that's going to be tough for them to make up.
Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. First carry for Dalvin Cook. And nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up.
Interception.
about set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something they can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit. Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. They keep on the ground. Able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 43 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. 10th carry now for Elliott. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. This defense, Charles, really played well in that win a week ago.
Well, we certainly had a nice conversation with the defensive coordinator, didn't we? And what we heard, I like what we did.
This is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 33. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And that will give us the very rare scoreline of 5-0. So the turnover leads to points as they add 3 there.
Yeah, what a sequence there, and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And they interplay here in this one on a 2-game win streak, plus they come off the open week as well, so this is a team that has a lot of things working in their favor.
Oh, it certainly is, and let's face it, this team is playing so well. The worry now is that after a few extra days off, they'll be sluggish coming into this game. So I've heard that he spent more time in practice working what they call good versus good, starting offense versus starting defense. They want a fast start in this next game.
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll start by handing it off to Dalvin Cook. Sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Second down, they go right back to Cook. The pickup there, and it's a first down.
And that's why Dalvin Cook is the Minnesota Vikings featured back. You put the ball in his hands, good things happen. Second in the NFL last year in rushing with 1,557 yards, and that's now back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons with 30 combined total touchdowns. What a player is Dalvin Cook.
good run by Cook. Here's another first and 10. To throw, Cousins. He's going to get this one down to Cook. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make this a second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it can turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Throwing again on second down. Cousins, and this one complete to Smith. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4 yard pickup leaves him with third and one.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46. It goes as a gain of 9, and it moves the chains.
Third and partner, no need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
First and 10 at the 46. On the ground, it's Cook. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It's only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And the last run got 3. Now here's second and 7. Here's Cousins. And that's taken in. It's BC Johnson. First time that they call his number tonight, and it gets him a first down.
They all came together there in breaking route, drilled it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Cousins gives way to Cook. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
Yeah, things are pretty stacked up there in the middle of the lot. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Still 9 remaining on second down. To throw it is Cousins. And the pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. DeMarcus Lawrence, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
That's 3 sacks now, and that's not much of a surprise to me, nor should it be to you. This team, they lead the league in sacks.
Yeah, they do. This is something that we are starting to witness time and time again.
Cousins with work to do after the sack as he brings his guys up on a third and long. Throwing his Cousins. And the man complete. That's Cook. And he'll be brought down. Looks like right at the 40. That'll bring up fourth down. They wind up getting 8 yards, but they needed more than that. Thank you.
So on fourth down, Britton Colquitt on the punt. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports.